Everyone in Moomin Valley slept all through the winter. But when the last of the deep snow melted, spring came. Time to wake up. Moomin Troll had slept 100 nights and 100 days and was finding it difficult. But then he caught sight of Snufkin's empty bed and was wide awake at once. "Upon my tail," he said, "Snufkin has woken up before me. Where is he?"
Oh!
He could see Snufkin's footsteps plainly in the wet earth and set off at once to follow his tracks. He must have been very pleased, he thought. He did a cartwheel here. Suddenly, he lifted his nose and listened. Down by the river, Snufkin was playing a happy song. "Hello, Snufkin," said Moomin Troll. But Snufkin went on playing. He was composing a tune to the spirit of spring. When it was finished, he put his flute in his pocket and they went to wake up Sniff. Sniff always slept a week longer than anyone else. Under Sniff's window, they made their secret signal. "What's up?" shouted Sniff crossly. "I'm still asleep." "Come down," shouted Snufkin. "We're going to celebrate waking up." "Today we're going to climb to the top of the lonely mountain and build a pile of stones to show we were the first there on the first day of spring." In the forest, the spirits that haunted the trees and the woodland creatures were all awake. "Happy spring," shouted Snufkin. The higher up the hill they went, the less people there were. But when they reached the top at last, they found someone else had been there before them. There lay a hat, a tall black hat.
"Too big for me," said Moomin Troll.
"And it's too new for me," said Snufkin, who loved his old hat far too much ever to want a new one. "Let's take it home," said Sniff. "Come on," said Snufkin. "I'm dying for some breakfast." "Yes, yes," said Sniff. "Let's go." And that's how they found the hobgoblin's hat and took it home with them. They didn't know that this would cast a spell on the Valley of the Moomins. When Moomin Troll, Snufkin and Sniff returned from the lonely mountain, bringing with them the tall black hat, everyone else had already had their breakfast. Only Moomin Popper was left, reading his newspaper. "Look, Popper," said Moomin Troll, "a beautiful new hat for you."
"Ah.
Popper tried it on, very carefully.
It was rather too big for him. Mama, screamed Moomin Troll, come and look at Papa.
Oh,
how do I look?
Asked Moomin Papa. Said Moomin Mama. Yes, you look very handsome, of course, but I almost think you look more dignified without a hat. So they put the hat on the floor, and Papa said it would make a very good waste bin. Eat your eggs, children, said Moomin Mama. You certainly need feeding up after living on pine needles all winter. Ooh, lovely. Breakfast, said Sniff.
Ooh, I love eggs, said Snufkin.
Me too, said Moomin Troll. So they ate their eggs and, like tidy Moomins, when they'd finished, threw their eggshells into the hat and went out. Then something really strange happened. The eggshells began to change into soft, woolly white clouds. The hat was magic. It truly belonged to the hobgoblin. The clouds looked just like smoke. What's this? Said Snufkin. The snort maiden thought the house was on fire. Cautiously, she patted the nearest rug. Just like a little pillow, said Snufkin. Sniff gave one of the clouds a gentle push and disappeared into it. Let me try, said the snort maiden. Then they all threw themselves onto the clouds. They had terrific fun, even floating up to the treetops and past the Moomin house.
Yoo-hoo, Mama!
What have you found now, said Moomin Mama.
Be careful you don't fall down.
Snufkin played a floating song and they glided on over the valley where they could see the Hemulin wandering alone in a very sad mood. Sniff dive-bombed him.
Oh, how you frightened me, cried the Hemulin.
Look what we're riding on, said Sniff.
Really, said the Hemulin, I am so used to your extraordinary doings that nothing surprises me. Besides, I'm too melancholy to be interested. I have nothing to do.
Why not study nature, suggested the young Moomins.
What a day! That's it, exclaimed the Hemulin. That's what I'll do. I'll collect plants. Oh, Floriat!
Snufkin played on, and the young Moomins drifted across the spring sky feeling like butterflies in the breeze. Perhaps it's a sign, thought Moomin Troll, as the first real butterfly of spring fluttered past. A sign of something strange. But by this time, everyone else was feeling hungry, so they steered their clouds for home, where Moomin Papa and Moomin Mama were anxiously waiting. And nobody knew that the clouds had had anything at all to do with the hobgoblin's hat. One warm summer day, it began to rain steadily in Moomin Valley. It was too wet to be out of doors. Inside the Moomin house, the Hemulin was sorting out his dried flower collection, but everyone else was very bored. The Snork Maiden tried out different earrings, but she didn't like any of them. Sniff was asleep as usual. Snufkin decided they needed cheering up. Let's play blind man's buff, he suggested. We must try to be quiet, though, said Moomin Troll, because Papa is upstairs in his study, writing his memoirs. Sniff began to count. 100.
Coming!
Moomin Troll couldn't decide where to hide. Then he caught sight of the tall black hat. What a brilliant idea. Sniff would never think of looking there. Poor Moomin Troll. He didn't know that whatever stayed in the hobgoblin's hat long enough changed into something quite different. Sniff soon found everyone else, and then they all joined in the search for Moomin Troll.
But by this time he was tired of waiting under the hat, so he shouted, "Here I am." "What's that?" said Sniff. "I say, look at this. Come on, help me. 1, 2, 3. Heave. Heave. Oh, come on now, all together. Heave. Oh." The Moomins were horrified. Who was this stranger? They didn't know it was really Moomin Troll who'd been changed by the hat. "Who's that?" said the Snort Maiden. Moomin Troll thought they were only pretending, so he said, "I'm the King of California." "And I'm the Snork Maiden," said the Snork Maiden. "I'm Sniff," said Sniff. "I'm Snufkin," said Snufkin. "Oh, gee, how boring you all are," said Moomin Troll. "Couldn't you make up something funnier? Now, let's go outside. It ain't raining no more." Outside, the Himulin was very surprised to see what he thought was a newcomer. "Who's that, then? Is he going to live here?" asked the Himulin. "That's for Moomin Troll to decide," said Sniff. "I wonder where he's got to. Do you know him?" he asked the King of California. Now, Moomin Troll still thought they were only teasing him, so he said, "Oh, yeah, I know him. And he's a real pain. I can't stand him." "How dare you?" cried the Snork Maiden. "He's the best Moomin in the whole world." "Is that so?" said Moomin Troll. "I reckon he's real screwy."
"Oh, you ugly old king," said Sniff. And before Moomin Troll realized it wasn't just a game, he found himself underneath a pile of flailing paws and tails.
"What are you doing there, children?" cried Moomin Mama. "Stop fighting at once."
"They're walloping the King of California," said the Snork Maiden, "and it serves him right."
"Never mind, it's gone far enough."
"Mama," shouted Moomin Troll, "they started it. 3 against 1, it's not fair."
"I quite agree," said Moomin Mama, "but who are you, my little beast?"
"I'm me," cried the unhappy Moomin Troll. "Oh, please, it isn't funny anymore. I really am Moomin Troll. Look carefully at me, Mother. You must know your own Moomin Troll."
Moomin Mama looked into his frightened eyes. "Yes, you are my Moomin Troll," she said. And at once he changed back into himself again. "It's all right now, my dear," said Moomin Mama. "You see, I shall always know you." Afterwards, Moomin Troll and Snufkin tried to understand what had happened. "Perhaps someone bewitched you," said Snufkin.
"No," said Moomin Troll, "no one bewitched me. But I was sitting under the black hat a long time."
Once Moomin Troll and Snufkin realized that anything placed inside the hobgoblin's hat changed into something else, they wanted to test it at once. "Perhaps we could lure someone else into it," suggested Moomin Troll. "An enemy, like the pig swine or the ant lion." The ant lion had once pulled Moomin Mama into a hole and sprayed sand in her eyes. So they set out straight away, taking a big storage jar to catch the ant lion. Down by the seashore, they looked along the beach for his home and soon found it.
"What do we do now?" said Snufkin.
"Shh, leave it to me," whispered Moomin Troll. "You'll soon see. Just watch this." "Give me the jar."
"These antlions are very weak creatures," said Moomin Troll loudly. "Very weak. Pathetic fellows altogether. They are, I tell you. Ouch!"
And then a threatening head with staring eyes popped up.
"Did you say weak?" hissed the antlion. "I can dig myself down in 3 seconds flat."
"Show us how it's done then," said Moomin Troll.
And the boastful Antlion dug himself down so fast he didn't see the jar until it was too late. Quick, the lid! Gotcha! Right, now for the hat. Back to the Moomin house. What's all this? What have you got there? Asked Sniff. An Antlion, said Moomin Troll proudly. Get the hat. We're going to put him in and see what happens.
Oh, mirabile dictu.
Hurry up. Now, come along. Sniff thought it would be a good idea to put a very thick book on top of the hat in case the Antlion climbed out. In a cloud of sand, the Antlion tumbled out, and Sniff quickly popped the dictionary on top. Then they all dived behind the table while the change took place.
He could turn into absolutely anything, thought Moomin Troll. Something even more dangerous than an Antlion who would gobble us all up.
Water began to drip from the brim of the hat and began to spread over the floor. Then the pages of the dictionary crinkled, and out came the words, changed into creepy crawlies that soon spread everywhere. The words crawled, the water dripped, then a very small wet hedgehog appeared. That was all that was left of the Antlion. When Moomin Mama came home, the place was flooded and the ceiling was covered with crawling words. What a mess, said Moomin Mama crossly. What have you been doing? So Moomin Troll had to explain everything. Moomin Popper took it very seriously indeed and said the hobgoblin's hat must be destroyed. The hedgehog wandered sadly out. Moomin Mama cleared away the words, and that night the Moomins took the hat down to the river and threw it in.